My name is Nicholas Becker, and I work for Microsoft AI for Good. Growing up, I wanted to be an astronaut. I still do. I hope to go to space someday. But that led me to science and math, and my interest just bloomed. So I didn't get any access to computer science or coding until I was in college. And that gave me the background to bring several different disciplines of technology together. The airline industry is one of the world's biggest environmental impactors. Globally, it makes up 2.5% of total global emissions. A parked plane waiting at a gate burns 60 to 80 gallons of jet fuel per hour. But there are other sources of power for an aircraft while they're on the ground. We started working with the Port of Seattle and SeaTac to try to tackle this issue. We used off-the-shelf components, Raspberry Pis, sensors, 3D printed parts to try to collect the necessary information to train AI models to detect this needless emission. And as we went along, we iterated to more and more mature devices. We created a distributed sensor network to monitor these emissions in real time. This network can then tell the airport which airplanes need to have their engines shut down to mitigate these emissions.
All right, we are as prepared as possible.
Oh, it was so much fun to work on it, you know, climbing around on top of jet bridges and around and underneath the airplanes and installing sensors all around the airport to try to collect the necessary information to solve this problem. It was a pretty incredible experience to see, like, we can do this. We can stop these emissions. This is a great solution because everybody benefits. The airlines benefit from fuel savings and hitting their environmental targets. The airports hit their environmental targets and have a healthier work environment for their personnel on the ground. And the consumers benefit because their individual impact is now lower while flying. I don't come from a traditional computer science background, but today all of the science and engineering disciplines require some levels of computer science. So now everybody's a developer, whether they had that background or not. If you want to solve a really big problem, the tools available today have made that easier than ever.